Hello, Eco Gypsy. One of the other things I'm in the middle of at the minute is sorting out this big top that we went and collected on a road trip not so long ago. I'll show you where we're up to, and you can see where we are. We're sort of getting ready for a bit of a dry run to put it up and see what it actually looks like, what we've got. So I'll show you what we've done so far. These are the uprights that go around the edge of the main tent. They've had a coat of undercoat, they need filling and top coating. These are the main poles, steel poles, the black ones that are the main parts. The yellow JCB yellow are all the pegs, and we've made a few heavy duty stakes for the ground. Some more there, they need painting. Kevin's here today to see if we can get these base plates on. Now what these do is they sit on the bottom of the pole to just give it a bit more stability, and when you pull the tent up, they sort of pivot onto these plates, and you stake the plates out into the ground. So we're gonna, as you can probably hear, the grinders going, see if we can get them put on.
Okay, so when these are lying down, to fix this hinge in like that, so when it's upright it'll stand on the plate, but when it's on the ground before you lift it, this bit will be lying on the ground like that, and then as you pull the post up, it'll go like this and then stand upright on the plate.
So that just gives it a bit more stability, and you can then stake the plate into the ground.
Yeah, it stops the bottom from going either side.
Yeah.
And just gives this a good solid base for it to... I mean, they don't really go anywhere, but... like that.
Yeah, ideal.
Might be good to put something in here, just so some idiot doesn't pull it out.
Yeah.
Just for safety, but
if we drill a hole in through the plate where one of them little holes are, we could just put a stake in there.
Yeah, that's right.
All made out of recyclables.
Yeah.
Upcycled, Kevin, that's
upcycled.
What they say.
Oh, upcycled, that's the word.
So here at the child labour camp, the boot camp for naughty kids.
Yeah.
We've got them here. This'll teach them to go to school and be good citizens. So poles are coming on, they're all ready for top coat, and nearly ready for top coat.
So we're going to have quite an interesting day today. We've finished painting the main poles, and we've done some base plates and some other bits and pieces, so we're sort of prepped up and ready for a dry run, really. So we're going to see if we can get it up today here, see what bits we're missing and what state everything's in. And then we'll be ready to move it to the burrito site. So yeah, keep watching, should be good.
What's going on?
Well, so we got the main guy cables, these ones.
They're the reinforced ones there, yeah.
And on the right there is the chain blocks to lift the ridge bar up. I need to just measure these so I can get the Sokatoa, work out the...
Don't be... bamboozling, see, with your big words.
Hypotenuse. We've got the upright from the poles. This will be the hypotenuse of the triangle, and if I do a calculation, we should be able to find out where to put the stakes in.
The hypotenuse is the longest side.
Oh, hello.
What'd you say, Carl? Carl, Mr. Clever.
Just tell him.
So all them years of me dragging you to school and making you do as you're told, and then what did you just say? Right, okay. I'm learning some shit today. Hypotenuse and Sokatoa. What, Sokateri is what?
Sokatoa is about the only thing I remembered in maths.
Right.
So sine is the opposite of the hypotenuse, the cosine is the adjacent over the hypotenuse, and the tangent is the opposite over the adjacent. I wish they'd have given me some more of those little things, and I might have been better at maths.
Me and Lev aren't saying anything, are we? Yeah. Sounds like a lady I once knew.
we've got 9 on the upright jack.
Pole.
No, foot.
9 metres.
9 metres.
12 metres on the cable.
You got your phone?
On a 3-4-5 triangle, is it?
Yeah. Right.
So these are the base plates.
Yeah.
And this is the ridge bar.
Yeah.
And so we can use that ridge bar to calculate where the base plates want to go.
Yeah.
Because obviously the poles are going to sit in here, and this is going to go on the bottom of the pole, so it'll slide up when we pull it up.
Ah, right. I wondered what the things are on there for.
And the calculation of Sokotoa wants to work out how far from here we need to put the stake in for the guy ropes, which is 8 metres.
Okay.
Get the poles in the bottom here, the bottom half of the poles, slide this ridge bar on.
Yeah.
Looks like it needs to be straightened a bit, really. Maybe get a scaffold bar in there, pole in there, and then lever it up a bit just to flatten this out.
Oh, that ring?
That ring, yeah. It's just bent down.
All right. Get a sledgehammer. Can you get them 2 poles over, Lev and Jack? Them 2 poles and that sledgehammer, wherever it is. It's over there somewhere.
Circus sledgehammer.
Ah.
That's it.
A circus sledgehammer.
To kill you on a... It might be a thing.
Yeah, it might just bend down.
Not with that one, it
won't. That was good, yeah. I've got that on foot. That's,
yeah,
I got that on film. That circus sledgehammer.
It hasn't been used for a few years.
Yeah, obviously since the 1950s. Right, get my sledgehammer.
Right.
There we go.
What are we trying to do? Just bend it straight.
Yeah, we need to put a pole in there and lever it. Stand
on here
and lever it.
You've got a short scaffold pole over there.
No.
So there's the structure there. You see the sort of height of it. I'm just going to lay these main guides out, and then hopefully we'll be able to. It should pivot up from these base plates. So we've just got to lay the canvas over to start with, though. So these are the side panels, Kevin.
These are the side walls, yeah.
They don't look bad considering they've been in the shed for 15 years.
No rot on them. The Velcro clips to that edge. Door. It's quite a lot of area, isn't it?
Yeah. So 8?
7 metres, so if there's 4, it's 28 metres in circumference all the way around. And these are...
Let's pull that up there, Jack.
About 7 foot. Walls,
yeah,
7 foot high, so out here, the edge can sit.
Cool. Oh. There we go. So we've got another that poles to go on top of that pole, so that'll give you an idea of the height of it. Cool.
Going on that
pole.
On that pole.
Yeah. Oh, so it's going on right.
It's
okay.
Going over there.
Oh, so you're putting on like a duvet backwards.
Yep.
Then?
Yeah.
Right, okay.
And that's what I mean, should have laid it down first.
Yeah, well. We're gonna give you a little bit of leeway today.
Right, can we put this down there now?
Yeah, you can put that one down. Go anywhere at the moment.
Oh, it's spun now.
Just spun around, no, spin a bit more.
Which way are you spinning, Joe? That way.
Yeah, these pegs need to be.
Always loved it.
Yeah, things are getting bad now.
Yeah.
There's, if I get on the end,
What, white?
How about that one? Can you draw that one?
That's
it. That's muscle.
Come on, Jack, join in.
Go on, Jack.
Yeah. Show us up with this body.
Yeah.
It must be hot today. Get that light in there.
Right, tent master, where are we up to at this point?
Okay, we've got all the cables on, got the
guide ropes
on, block to pull the tent up, which you'll see a bit later. We've now got to lift these poles up and put on the A-frame so they're up at an angle so that it's easier to pull it up with the truck, because we'd never pull it off the ground with that sort of leverage.
We're short on gypsies today. If we had a few more gypsies on site, we'd definitely get it up,
definitely,
no trouble at all.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
I can't do it on my own.
No.
So A frame it is.
Well, it could take two or three of us to lift this. And somebody on the A needs to follow up behind on the A frame as we go up.
Karen, get on the A frame.
Maybe Jack or Karen or whatever. So it's like, you know, at that angle so it sticks in the ground, wide as it'll go. Just follow the pole down. We've got to get as high as we can and get this under. It's going to be beyond that.
The joint.
Beyond that joint.
All right.
Are they together?
Right. Yeah, they're fine.
It's about here.
Well, we'll see. We might want to, you know, best to get as high as we can, really. It's just a lot less strain on the, on that. So, I don't, do you want to go on here?
Yeah, no, it's all right.
Some.
And then we're just going to have to...
That's a bit in them. Go on, Jack.
Right. Come behind us, Jack.
Behind us.
You've got to move forward, Jack. Lev, can you go forward a bit?
I can.
All right, you move forward.
Yeah.
Reuben, right, hold it there and then I'll come in.
Yeah, come on.
Them nice wood poles would have been lovely.
Yeah,
good. You got it under there, Jack?
I'm under, but...
Well, come down here then with it. Poke it under between me and Lev.
Yeah.
Whoops. Well, the chain out from under it.
There?
Yeah, but it needs to lean back to me. So lean forward. Right, open at the bottom.
Open up the bottom and kick the bottom towards Kevin. There you are, that's it.
Okay. Do you want to get that chain on the inside there? Come on.
Is there a lift again?
Hang on, there's no weight. Hang on, just let that weight.
Just sit on the edge of that. Alright, that's alright, Jack.
Alright.
Lev should be at the back, he's the tallest.
Yes,
Alright, go on, Jack, push up behind Lev. Go on. That's it. Open the bottoms up.
Got the nail on the back.
Right. Oh, I've just got my bike.
Yeah. Alright,
is it in?
Yeah, you're on.
Yeah, Karen's right. I should be at the front.
Is it short?
Yeah. I'm like that.
Yeah, doing nothing unusual.
Lev's bent over.
Yeah. You need them A-frames, didn't you?
Yeah.
Don't
worry,
you're on
them.
This
one.
I can see Jack, you're not working on
this one.
Oh no!
Put it this way, it'll pull against Jack's cable then.
Shall I let it loose a little bit?
No.
Is that recording?
No, just keep it on as it is, Jack. Just hold on to your rope. No, that doesn't matter. We can adjust
that
it in a minute.
That one's just slacked off.
Hey?
Yeah, that one's just slacked off.
Yeah, but it will.
Mm.
So you can pull on with this arm and hold tight with that one, okay? I'll tighten it smart again.
You want me to pull on that one, Kev?
Yeah, that's right. If you're at that angle. There, the feet down there.
Yeah, once we get it sort of far up, we'll feed
it. Yeah, it's about this height.
Yeah, feed it back in.
And then we go underneath.
It's been a fantastic day, really enjoyable. Sun's been blazing hot all day. We've got the tent up. I'll give you a little tour, show you inside. It's got a really beautiful feeling inside here, really nice. Temperature's a lot cooler as well. But I'll show you up there. We've got a couple of tiny little holes in, but nothing major. Obviously there's sides to go on here which we'll put on. I've got 5 uprights to make and a load of tent. We run out of sort of ropes today and we run out of tent pegs today, so I've got to get some more of them. But all in all, the main part of it's up, so yeah, it's been really, really cool. So I'm not claiming to be a circus tent expert or anything, but I think we've done quite well considering. Kevin hasn't put this up for 15 years and none of us have done one before, so we sort of managed to get it up and suss out what we were doing and what we'd done wrong. So by the time we put it up again, I think we'll have a bit more of a gist with it. So we're just going to get the poles sorted and the bits that are missing, and get it up on the Eco Burrito site. I think it's going to look really, really cool up there. And give us a bit of cover for the summer. So thanks for watching the video. Catch us on the next one, and take care.